Hello, my name is Brent Douglas. I'm an audio production student at the New England Institute of Art and will be receiving my associate's degree in April 2012. My love for music and performance started at the age of 10 when I joined my middle school band. I played everything I could get my hands on, including brass, strings, and percussion. I spent much time honing my musical skills and got the opportunity to try out for and participate in 6 district music festivals, eventually receiving the 2006 Woody Herman Jazz Award for my accomplishments as a bass player. At the age of 14, my band, School in the Walls, started to record our first demo. We used an old Tascam 4-track tape recorder, had no idea what we were doing, and it sounded awful, but I loved every step of the process. I had more fun engineering the project than performing my parts. That was when I decided my true love was audio production. A few years later, I got a priceless opportunity. For my junior and senior year, I had the privilege to attend a technical high school for half the day studying digital audio and video electronics. I learned basic system flow, studio maintenance, miking techniques, recording, editing, and mixing in Pro Tools and Logic Pro on a control surface, soldering, shot composition, Final Cut Pro editing, and sound replacement in Soundtrack Pro. I worked hard and was rewarded by winning the River Valley Technical Center Producers Award 2 years in a row for my recordings, as well as receiving the Blind Luck Recording Scholarship. I never thought I would have the ability to pursue an education higher than what the Tech Center could offer me in audio. That all changed when I received a $30,000 scholarship to the Art Institute of Washington. I spent 1 year there sharpening my skills by taking classes such as Survey of the Music Industry, Music and Studio Business, Music Fundamentals, Introduction to Audio, Remote and Field Recording, and Digital Audio Workstations. After my second semester, I transferred to the New England Institute of Art to finish out my associate's degree. My first class at the New England Institute of Art was Audio Recording 1 in Studio F. In this class, I learned how to operate a multi-track recording device, a 16-channel Mackie mixer, send headphone mixes into the vocal booth, and run the TOF console accurately and efficiently, as well as how to patch in outboard EQ, compressors, and reverb units into a patch bay. My final project in Audio Recording 1 was to book time in Studio F and do a 24-track mix of a song on the TOF console, which you are currently listening to. So much fun to be having. While taking Audio Recording 1, I also took Audio Technology 2 with David Lefkowitz. In this class, we focused on system flow by doing system block diagrams, basic mixing techniques, as well as the theory and proper use of spectral, dynamic, and time-based effects. My final project in this class was to do a system block diagram of the Mackie mixer found in Studio F. It was very tedious and daunting, but in retrospect, it helped me a lot with the concept of signal flow in a console. Listening and analysis reiterated much I learned in Audio Technology 2 concerning spectral, dynamic, and time-based effects, but added how to do SBL readings and music theory to its list of core objectives. For music theory, we learned basic rhythmic notation and how to build major and minor scales in any key. The final project for this class was to research a producer or engineer and do a presentation on them in front of the class. I chose one of my favorite producers and engineers, John Feldman. For most, this was a pretty simple and straightforward assignment, but for me, it was much more difficult. I find it very hard to stand up in front of people, especially my peers, and speak or show my work. Doing this assignment, though, definitely increased my confidence in my social and presentation skills. This semester, one of the classes I'm taking is Live Sound Reinforcement with Rick Smith. The course focuses on running a professional live sound system, including front of house and monitor mixing, signal flow, troubleshooting, feedback control, and proper equipment handling and care. Each week, we are expected to book time in the live sound room with a partner and set up the live rig setup we did in class that week. This class has been extremely valuable, seeing as I have not had much experience running live sound and find satisfaction in learning something new from the class each and every week. I am also taking Audio Recording 2 with Al Shapiro in Studio B. This class takes what I learned in Audio Recording 1, expands on it, and lets me apply it in a more real-world way. I've learned how to run a Trident Series 80 console, patch effects and talkback mics, as well as reroute signal through Studio B. I also learned techniques to properly mic and mix guitars, bass, drums, and vocals. My final project for this class was to record and mix 2 songs for a band. I decided to record my fellow classmates' band, In Fear of Our Dreams.
I was a little pressed for time, but worked really hard, and I think everything came out really well. Currently, you're listening to one of the tracks I recorded for this project.
As well as audio recording 2 and live sound reinforcement, I am also taking hard disk recording in Studio D with Sean McLaughlin. In this class, we focus on Pro Tools Quick Keys, recording and mixing through the Yamaha O2R digital console, as well as working with two-track and multi-track mixes and sound design for motion picture. As well as sharpening my accuracy and speed with Pro Tools and mixing, I have gained valuable experience routing signal through a digital studio setup, working with 16-channel audio, and troubleshooting in a digital studio. All things I had not had much experience with until this class. For my final project, I had to replace all audio, including dialogue and effects, for a film trailer.
The trailer I chose for my project was for the film Blue Valentine. While working on this, like with any project, I encountered several problems, but by working through them, I learned a lot. I hope you enjoy my trailer for the film Blue Valentine.
I can't really sing. I have to sing goofy in order to sing, like I have to sing stupid, okay?
Okay.
You always hurt the ones you love, the ones you should hurt at all. You always take the sweetest rose, then crush it. Petals fall. You always break the kindest hearts, and with a hasty word you can.
You're actually good.
Recall.
Slow dance to this part.
And if I broke your heart last night, it's because I love ya most of all.
Woo!
I was required to do an 80-hour internship for my industry seminar class as well. Finding an internship was probably the hardest assignment I've ever been given. I spent weeks calling and emailing places for hours a day. When finally, I got the chance to interview at the Dorchester Boys and Girls Club, working in the music clubhouse. After spending a week worrying about how the interview went, I got the call informing me that I had been accepted as an intern. When I went in for my first day, I figured I would just shadow someone around and learn as I went. Instead, the first thing I was told was that I was the recording studio supervising manager, and had an hour to plan, submit, and get approved a 10-week schedule for a recording class, and a schedule of activities for the kids who come to the club. Once the kids arrived an hour later, I was thrown into a melting pot of positive musical energy. Kids were all over the place, playing guitar, drums, piano, and singing. That day, I taught an introduction to Pro Tools class in their small studio to around 10 kids between the ages of 10 and 18, as well as ran two hip-hop sessions, and acted as a voice coach for a young girl in the evening. Every Wednesday and Friday, when I come in to teach my weekly recording class and run sessions for the kids, my already present love for teaching adolescents music and the recording arts is reiterated. I feel like I have gained more patience and understanding with children, which is a must if I want to further my career as an audio teacher. Being able to share with them some of the knowledge I've learned over the years has been an extremely rewarding experience. Thank you very much for viewing my portfolio. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to ask.